All right, setting up your vehicle for emergencies. I'm going to talk about how I set up my SUV, my Tahoe, for emergencies. Some things I like to include in my vehicle. And first, in the front, start at the front, I like to have some type of GPS. It really depends on your situation. You can use your cell phone, but some GPS. I can still carry, so I like to have a way of securing firearms or money or whatever. Not that I'm rich, but just something to consider, some type of console safe. They're not cheap, but I think they are a really good option in case you have to go to a courthouse or a police station somewhere where you can't necessarily just carry guns inside. Fire extinguishers, really important. I usually have some type of extinguisher mounted in view. First aid kit, something that everybody should have in their vehicle. At least these two, for sure. Should have that in your emergency, as part of your emergency kit for your vehicles, absolutely. Another thing, let's move on to the back. All right, I like to have some type of sleeping bag. That's really important to me, having a sleeping bag in case I have to end up sleeping in this vehicle. Another thing, some type of blanket as well. This is a wool blanket. Still has a tag on it, but water, definitely. You just never know. Now, in this compartment down here, I actually have freeze-dried food and MREs right down there. I got some backpackers pantry freeze-dried food. I also have some Mountain House freeze-dried food, a few MREs, but some basic stuff, tire plug kit, air compressor. Great air compressor, by the way. Don't go cheap on it. Noco booster. You get the vehicle boosted if the battery dies for whatever reason. I've used this to rescue so many people, it's crazy. Both here in Georgia and in Kentucky. All right, you don't really need this, but it's just an option. A drill set, basic mechanic set. Some type of jack, emergency bag filled with, you know, emergency food, MRE stuff, water filter. Has basic tools like knives. This is Narcan. Some other tools in there. Flashlights. Weatherproof matches. A lot of first aid, trauma stuff. Some gloves, compress. That's designed to stop the bleeding. Basic tools, multi-tool. This is actually a baton. Really interesting item to have in your emergency bag, but a knife, but you get the picture. This is actually a trauma bag. This is just totally dedicated to just stopping the bleed, trauma issues, scissors, compress, tourniquet, stuff like that. So just want to give you an idea of how I set up an SUV, and you guys can tell me what I'm missing. Any thoughts? The only other thing I would add would be a dash camera. I haven't got around to adding a dash camera, which is something I love to do. At least have a camera focus out towards the road. This time when I get a dash camera, I'm probably gonna have one focus. I might probably have at least two, one towards the road and one inside a cabin. So it's just a really cool thing to have options for videos. When I transport people, if that's an issue, if that's something I have to do, I'll at least have a video record of everything I said when they were in the vehicle. I mean, just never know. You know, somebody might try to say you said something or you did something. If you have a video camera, dash camera, then, you know, you can refute whatever the heck they're saying. But that wouldn't be my primary reason for doing that. I'd probably do that for, like, videos, for content or something like that. just something to think about. It's really important to have some type of video dash cam pointing outwards. That's not necessarily for emergencies, not SHTF emergencies, but just regular life emergencies, things that happen when you're on the road. So these are my thoughts on how I like to set up my SUV for, you know, emergencies as a prepper. I'm sure I can do a lot more, but I don't want to put so much stuff in here that it's like I'm living in the place. I still want it to look somewhat normal, you know. I don't want to have AR-15 rifles or AKs just laying right here and there, and, you know, have like a list of like just a bunch of magazines attached onto the back seat or something like that. No. But I still want to have enough resources so I have some options in case there is an emergency. So thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.